So just as, before we get started, just wondering, who is on the line?
So Dan Zachary.
Margot.
Jocelyn Day.
Kyle Hildebrand.
Barry Ransky.
Lynn Follansbee.
Farhan Shatkai.
That's Brian Hurley.
Hey, can we slow down? I want to make sure we get, let's start over. I want to make sure I get everyone's name here. So who went first?
Steve, I think there's a lot on the line. You might want to just go down the list.
Yeah, call the roll.
Yeah, we can do that. Is there anyone on for AARP? What about America's Communication Association? How about Americans for Tax Reform? Call for Action.
Here, Shirley Rooker.
Hey, Shirley. All right, how about Consumer Technology Association?
Hi, this is Rehan Hassan filling in for Rachel Nemeth from CTA.
Okay. Consumer Reports.
Yes, George Slover.
CTIA. And Barry, you're on?
Yep, I am.
Eric Koch?
Steve can hardly hear you.
Is Eric Koch there? How about Kyle?
On. Kyle's on.
Okay. And Johnny?
I'm here.
Great.
There you go.
Michael? Santorelli, he's out. Okay, how about Milwaukee PBS?
He's on. Bodan Zachary's here.
Good. Debbie, I heard your voice.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, and National Consumer Law Center?
Margaret Saunders, I'm on.
Thank you. NCTA?
Yes, Steve Morris is here.
Trevor Project?
This is Sam Brinson. We're here.
And U.S. Telecom.
They're not here.
Okay, they're not. Okay, so we have a quorum. So let's begin. Okay, so
Larry Walk from the National Association of Broadcasters also here.
Larry.
Okay.
Okay. And Brian Hurley from AC Connect is also here.
Okay. Larry and Brian.
Jocelyn Day and William Benetton from MassDTC is here.
Okay. All right. Well, good. Yeah, it's good, very good turnout. So today we're going to walk through a recommendation from the Robocall Report Working Group. Now that we have the attendance out, we have a quorum. I'll just start really just by saying thanks for everyone who did this and the hard work and dedicated efforts to put this together in such a very, very short time frame. So thank you again. So just to start us off, we kind of want to understand what's getting proposed with an explanation of the recommendation before us. Let me call on Vonda and Chris to go ahead and
Linda.
Yeah. And let's start with that. So if you could go through the proposal, please.
Okay, so I'll start. Yes, this is Chris over here. So I'm not going to read all the clauses to you because I assume you all have access for those of you who are on the phone. And for all of us who are here, you have a hard copy of that. So the whereas clauses acknowledge the following. That illegal and unwanted robocalls are consumers' top complaint to the FCC, as well as the consumer demand to take action to address this problem. That's clause number one. FCC's ongoing efforts to fight robocalls. Then we acknowledge industry's efforts and the variety of blocking tools and mechanisms developed. The possibility that consumers are unaware of the existing tools. The report on the state of deployment of advanced methods and tools directed by the Commission and expected to be submitted this upcoming June. The Commission's adoption of this committee's recommendation to study the implementation and effectiveness of blocking measures. That this is an evolving ecosystem, and accurate data and information are critical for developing sound policy responses. This is where I just summarize clauses 7 and 8. The need to be critical about the validity and reliability of specific metrics, for example, counting the number of robocalls or a number of consumer complaints that is not reflective of consumer experience or amount of fraud. And that there are specific factors that make the reporting on the effectiveness of robocall mitigation complex and challenging. For example, the lack of consistent definitions and metrics used in reporting. And all the other factors are listed under whereas clause 11. So with that, I'll hand it over to Linda.
Thank you. Hi, this is Linda Vandeloup. And on the recommendations, the recommended clauses encourage the Commission to collect data that provides useful feedback on the effectiveness of call blocking solutions, use consistent definitions of key terms, and clearly differentiate between unwanted and illegal calls, and adopt consistent and robust methodologies for analyzing the data collected. Undertake the development of metrics and methodologies in consultation with industry, consumers, and other relevant stakeholders. Measure the trends in and effectiveness of call blocking. Be informed by relevant research and reports. Reflect the consumer experience with call blocking tools in the Commission report. Collect available data from analytics engines, third-party call blocking providers, voice service providers, and others in a manner that minimizes excessive burdens on the respondents. Report on the status of enforcement against illegal robocallers. Conduct consumer surveys on the scope of the problem and awareness of available tools. And use the first report as a building block for future reports, given that the tools are new and there is insufficient data available now. So.
Okay, so, so we need to move to adopt.
We need a motion to adopt the recommendation.
All right, so would someone propose that? So we have a first, a second.
Wait.
And so, Sarah. First, Mark seconded. So let's move on to a discussion questions at this point. So it's open to the floor.
All right. This is Margo Saunders. I'm wondering why in the sixth whereas clause there's mention of fees that can be charged for call blocking when the TRACE Act prohibits that.
Hi, Margot. This is Chris. So we were just quoting the recommendation that was adopted.
Well, I don't know when those recommendations. I'm not quite sure what you're referring to. I'm looking at the whereas clause in the document that was sent to me a few hours ago.
Hi, this is Sarah from CTIA. It's a quote from the FCC's declaratory ruling in FNPRM. On call blocking from June of 2019.
Okay, well, since then the law has changed and it seems like it might be better for us to not be producing something that implied that it was okay to charge fees.
I think this paragraph of the FCC's item was just inquiring and directing the staff to take a survey of whether fees are being charged or not. The language, especially read in the context of the item, doesn't take a position on whether charging fees is okay or not. It just directs staff to inquire whether fees are being charged. And this paragraph goes to the directive to the staff to write the report So it really isn't expressing an opinion either way. And so I think it is appropriate to include it since it was part of the mandate to this working group.
Right, thank you.
We have other questions, comments? Anyone else from the floor?
Jocelyn, there's a typo, and I don't know if you want to make that edit now, I believe, in the recommended number 7, I believe. I believe it should be interactive. Yeah, number 12, I'm sorry. The recommended 12, second line, and conduct an interactive process?
Iterative.
Iterative.
Iterative, okay.
Iterative, yeah,
okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So is that fine? Okay, so is there anything else? We have anything else up for a question or discussion at this point? Okay, and hearing none, amendments. Any suggestions, amendments to be offered? Okay, hearing none. Then without further amendments, we'll proceed to a vote. All right, so can we hear everyone in the room and online? Who's in favor of the proposal? Say yay.
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 And those opposed, say nay. And do we have any abstentions on the line or in the room? Okay, so with that then, we have a recommendation to go to the chairman. So that was easy, another 100%. Thank you all for doing that. And again, thanks everyone for your hard work. It was another one of those short timeline initiatives, and once again, you came through. So thanks so much. And so this will conclude. For those who are on the Truth in Billing or are interested.
Comments from anybody?
Yeah, well, yeah, before we do that, yeah, are there any public comments at this point? And then I'll just mention too that that we will have a another call, what at 3 o'clock?
Well, actually we'll try to get it earlier than that.
Okay.
A 15-minute break, maybe, and we'll try to get our speaker down who says she's flexible.
Okay.
At the time.
Yeah. So.
And we can get started before 3 o'clock if you like.
Yeah. So then this we conclude the meeting this at this point, and what we'll do is we'll move on to a Truth in Billing, in about 15 minutes if everyone's available.
Yeah, next meeting's on the agenda.
Next yeah. And yeah, for those who are interested, then our next full meeting will be on the 27th of April. And so thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good day.